Today we're going to be demonstrating underwater weighing or hydrodensitometry. So our participant, our subject is going to be Professor Alev, and Professor Costa is going to be our test administrator. I'm just going to remind you that when we look at density of the body by underwater weighing, we're looking at mass divided by volume. So when we measure mass, Professor Alev will have her weight measured on a regular scale. We've done that up in the lab. And then when we look at volume, we're looking at the displacement of water or the loss of weight underwater. We have to adjust for residual volume, so we're going to use a formula that's based on height, age, and gender. So we've also measured her height, and then we'll also add in 100 milliliters for the GI gas. So we'll get underway.
Okay, at this time we are going to zero the platform, and the reason why we zero the platform is because the platform weighs a certain amount underwater and we need to subtract that amount from Alev's weight. So here we go. So I'm going to click zero. I need to ensure that there are no calibration weights on the tank and there's nothing resting on the white bars. Zero has been completed. Now I'm going to hit calibrate, and I'm going to take my two calibration weights. They weigh 2 kilograms each, and I'm going to place one on each of the white bars. I'm going to enter in 4 kilograms here in the software, press OK. The calibration weights are on the platform. And the calibration has been completed, so I'm going to go ahead and remove those weights. Okay, now we are ready to get started. So I'm going to ask Alev to swing her legs over and step directly down on the metal floor. Now Alev, now that you're in, I'd like you to face the door, please. And I'd like you to slowly lower your bottom down onto the platform. Just go ahead and sit down there. Excellent. Now I'd like you to sit with your legs crossed. Perfect. And go ahead and pat all of the bubbles out of your swimsuit. And then go ahead and get your hair wet as well. Excellent. So the reason why we have Alev sit directly on the platform and not stand on the platform is because the platform itself can only support 15 pounds of weight, and we wouldn't want that to snap right off. So it's really important that when you use this hydrostatic weighing tank, you step directly onto the metal floor and then gently sit yourself down onto the platform. Okay, Alev, are you ready? Okay.
I'm ready.
So we have some metal handles. Yep, just go ahead and grab onto those. In a moment, I will instruct you to slowly curl yourself into a ball, and as you're doing so, you're gonna exhale out all of your air. Exhale as fast and as hard as you can. And once you have all of the air out, hold it for a moment, and then you can pop right back up. Into position, yep, holding on to those metal handles.
I should be sitting on the platform.
Correct, yes, you should be sitting on the platform. Okay, so not yet. I'm going to go over to the computer because as soon as I see your head go underwater, I'm going to start the trial on the software. So I'm going to get that ready. Okay, whenever you're ready. Come on, Alev. Blow, blow, blow. All the bubbles, Alev. All the bubbles. Keep going, keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Great job. Okay, so the y-axis is her weight in kilograms. And then down here we have time in seconds. So we can see this green vertical line here, it's quite high, and that is her head out of the water. So she's going to weigh a little bit more with her head out of the water because we don't have that buoyancy. So all of this on this side is no good, so we need to move this bar over, and I actually have it in a spot where I think is a good place to start, because we can see that she is underneath the water here. And then I've moved the red line over this way because at this point she has popped right back out of the water and her head is out of the water. So her average weight in kilograms between the red and blue line is 1.75 kilograms. So when we move these bars around, it is going to change her underwater weight, and you can see her density and her body fat percentage changing as we move these bars around. If we were to move the bar over to where she had her head out of the water, we can see that her body fat percentage significantly decreases because of that change in weight. So when her head is out of the water, we can see these big green vertical lines, again, signifying that her head is out of the water. Even though that is the largest number, that is not her true underwater weight because her head is above the water. Usually when we do hydrostatic weighing, we perform 5 to 7 trials and we are attempting to get the best score. Usually our clients need about 5 to 7 trials because it takes some practice to exhale to residual volume.